Inside Press Box is presented by Maryland Live Casino. Always live, always on.
Join Press Box and Orioles Hangout for our next Hangout Night at Game Sports Bar this Friday, June 17th, as the Orioles take on the Blue Jays. You can get discounted Orioles tickets, food and drink specials at Game Sports Bar, and free parking. Just go to PressBoxOnline.com/hangout for full details.
And welcome back to Inside Press Box. Gary Stein alongside our special guest and co-host Gabby Gaudette. Terps football returns September 3rd to Capital One Field at Maryland Stadium when the Terps take on the Howard Bison. Here with his insight on what goes on between now and the opener, former Terps wide receiver, punt returner, and all-ACC pick in 2010, Tony Logan, welcome into the show. How are you?
Good. Thanks
and
for having me.
Good
here.
To have you back.
Absolutely.
And so this may seem kind of odd, but we're actually here to talk about what happens when you're not playing football.
Absolutely.
Because I don't think anybody really gives much thought after spring practice and the spring game, and now that school is out, football players, Maryland football players, have a couple of months to do what before the opener?
Well, in the summertime, the focus shifts to the strength and conditioning program. So now this is the time where the actual head strength and conditioning coaches and all of his assistants take the time to really delve into the speed, the agility, the power, the strength. What can we do to get these players, you know, better equipped so during camp they can be at their best? You know, during the school year, you don't have as much time with the players. The NCAA only allows you a certain amount of time per week to spend with these players. So you got to get in a lift. You got to get in a run, you got to have the meetings, you got to have the game film, all that. We're in the summertime, all that's lifted. You know, some of the players are taking a couple of classes, maybe to get ahead, you know, to make this the schedule lighter for the school year, or to catch up a little bit if they took a lighter load in the spring. But now the focus moves fully to, you know, player development. What can we do to get these players better? And then you still have a class of new guys coming in, and now you're just trying to throw everything on them, you know, get these guys strong. You know, you got 17-year-old, 18-year-olds. I remember coming into school, I was 170 pounds soaking wet, never really lifted weights in high school. Then you get to college, what do I do? You know, now it's that time to get these guys stronger. And then you have the older players where you already know some of those guys, so you know what they need to work on and improve on.
Now, you have different training programs in the off season, but what about, I'm curious, and you and I were talking about this before, what about diet? I know there's a, you know, you probably have a very regimented schedule during the on season, but what about the off season?
So in the off season, it's the same way. I think especially going into camp, they're really trying to tune these guys' body the right way. So it's really that time where they're trying to tweak little things and get them at their peak performance going into camp. Because like I said, once the school year starts, now you're kind of losing that time with the guys. So you're really trying to get, you know, whether it's a lineman who has to lose a couple pounds or a receiver or a running back and you're trying to gain them some pounds, you're really trying to keep their diet in order. So when I first got to school, we weren't as good on that. We didn't really have the dietitian there and the nutritionist and all that stuff. But now they have a full plan full year round. So even in the summertime, they can have the dining halls open and the, you know, the training tables, so these guys could come in, get a good meal in, you know what they need to eat, have some shakes before they lift, after they lift, to keep that thing going.
So it's interesting that you talk about that, because one of the criticisms of the program, whether it be during the Friesian years and then into the Etzel years, and now we'll see what happens with DJ Durkin, is that the Terps got pushed around a lot at the line of scrimmage on both sides of the ball. And, you know, just doing talk shows for all those years, the fans were saying, oh, they gotta lift better, they gotta get, you know, bigger and bulkier. I mean, do you think the Terps can do better in that category from your experience back in the day?
Well, with anything, it's with recruiting. I think over time you can do better in that. When I first got to Maryland, we actually came off a big bowl year with the Champ Sports Bowl. So when I first got there, we had some big guys. I was even scared to go out there. I'm like, I don't know what these guys, I'm like I said, I'm 17. I was young coming to college, and all these guys are huge. And I could tell the difference in the battles between the Florida States and the Clemsons. We were able to compete in those trenches. Whereas as I got older, we seemed to get a little bit smaller. And I think when Etzel came in, he really wanted this leaner team. He wanted the, you know, leaner, faster linemen, which worked with the ACC, but then we moved to the Big Ten. Now those guys are big. You know, you got the Wisconsins and Ohio States. These guys are recruiting big linemen. So I think it's just that transition. And now with Durkin coming in, I think now he transitions well and, you know, starts getting those recruits. And then over time, you'll start to see a bigger line. Guys aren't getting pushed around, and you still have some of the skill players coming in.
We're out of time, actually, but we got to have you back, and we are going to do more with you as far as Maryland football is concerned once it starts again. Tony, thank you so much for coming by.
Oh, thank you for having me.
Absolutely appreciate it. Hey, stay tuned for our Northwest BMW Photo of the Week when we return.
The Aberdeen Ironbirds kick off their season on June 22nd. Go to aberdeenironbirds.com to get your tickets today. Be sure to check out all the great family promotion nights. That's aberdeenironbirds.com.
Inside PressBox is presented by Maryland Live Casino. Always live, always on.